What is up?
What up?
You ready?
Hey, what's up? Thanks everyone for dropping in. We're about to get started. Gonna go live on Facebook. If you just hang tight. If it crashes, sorry. We'll try and work around that, but love you all.
It's gonna be perfect.
It's gonna be so good.
It's gonna be so spectacular.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. Two.
Is it live on the tube.
Public and post.
We're live on the tube.
Live on the tube. Hey.
Everyone's just like.
Live on Facebook too. Sorry, everyone. You probably didn't want to see me. Probably wanted to see her. Hold up. Let's not get started yet. I'm just setting up the camera. That's a pretty terrible angle. Oh, there we go.
Did you get it?
Yeah, it's slightly crooked, but you know what? We're working with it. Hi, everyone.
We're good.
Okay. About to get started. Thanks for hanging in there with us. Can you get a good view? Can you see it? I like that. What do you think, Pam?
Perfect.
Sound good?
Perfect.
Okay, is this it?
Mate. Mate,
it's time.
Okay. That was a good catch.
Where do I stand?
Come out when the music starts.
Are you already?
Okay, I'll go down.
We're live.
Why am I not seeing?
I don't know. Where do I stand?
That's a fair question.
Are you streaming on Facebook right now?
Yeah, Facebook and YouTube.
I don't have a Facebook show.
It should. Just go to Facebook, Abby's Live. I'm excited. Mom, do you have the stuff?
Yes.
Okay, great.
I'll bring it to you.
Do you want to check on your Facebook?
Brother B, do you want to come on up?
Sure.
Just open Facebook. Yeah.
I don't know when we get started. I can't even stand right here if you want to stand in the middle.
Hey,
Wes. Yeah. I don't have any kind of like live.
Yeah. If you go to the event,
it's
not.
Is Facebook
good? I'm just trying to make sure.
Yeah,
cool.
So,
what's your name?
Is on YouTube?
Avery, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
David.
Hello. Try just going on Facebook normally. Just go to the Facebook homepage.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Now you're live.
Okay. Yeah, just stay on the homepage, man. Right?
Yeah.
You guys look great. Oh, I think we're all live.
You got four people watching.
Where's the bride to be? Oh,
she's inside.
What's she doing?
We're waiting.
Doesn't she know this is starting already?
We need everybody out here.
Okay.
In their seats.
Not be a more lovely day.
I know, it's beautiful.
Apparently there is not a cloud in the sky.
I know. It's so nice.
That's true.
Are we all good to go?
Wow, now I'm all like beklempt. And this is just beautiful. On the behalf of the families and friends, we welcome you to this beautiful occasion. What a lovely day. I was telling Wes while we were standing here, I don't know that it could have been a more perfect occasion for this beautiful ceremony. There is not a cloud in the sky. We have the mountains in the background. And you both look so lovely and wonderful. Thank you for letting us be a part of this incredible event. What chaos has befallen us as of late over the past couple months with the virus breakout and quarantine, and that we haven't been able to see friends and loved ones. And for many of us, this is kind of a stepping out of that and starting to get back to life and normal. The fact that you guys planned this incredible event, hearing all of that, is quite remarkable and extraordinary. And it speaks to the love that you both share. For those of you who don't know me, I am David Bakavoy. I was invited to participate and to help perform this ceremony because I was actually Wesley's seminary teacher years ago. At Jordan High School. And I knew he was a special young man the moment I met him because he was so kind and loving and thoughtful and to everyone that he encountered. And then he walked into my office one day just out of the blue. I don't know if you remember this. And Wesley, he said, I have a gift for you. And here I am, a full-time LDS seminary teacher working for the LDS church. And he says, I have this gift for you, and it's a coffee mug. And I thought, I know I love this kid, but not only was it a coffee mug, but it had the Doors, which was like one of my favorite rock bands on it. And I thought, what a kind and wonderful, generous heart this young man has to pick up on that and to extend this incredible gift. And he and I cultivated a very deep and sincere friendship for that. And then got to know Abby through that, and what a lovely, wonderful person that she is. And inside, she's as lovely and beautiful as she is outside. So, am I supposed to? You want me over here? Okay.
Stand here and facelessly.
Oh, and I'm gonna take these off. So I look better. Okay.
Here, I think here.
Okay.
With your back to them.
Back to. Okay.
And then facing the house.
Okay, let's do that. It is wonderful that we can all be together like this as family and friends, and then virtually online to celebrate this incredible occasion. Let's turn the time. I didn't get a chance. Did you hear this, Pam, that you were going to be put on the spot?
No.
Okay. I meant to tell you this, but as we were preparing this incredible ceremony, Wesley and I thought that a nice way to start would be to invite someone to come up and talk about how the two met and just a little bit about their relationship. And he's immediately thought of you and thought that might be a nice thing to extend to you. So we're going to put you on the spot if that's okay, Pam, and have you come up and share a little bit about this wonderful couple.
Well, these two have been through so much. They met long ago in high school. They met and have been pretty much inseparable ever since. I can't say that the road has always been smooth, but I think that they have come a long way together, and they are well suited. We are absolutely thrilled to have Wesley join our family. I know that Weston is particularly happy to finally have a brother. And I don't really know what to say, except that I think that this is something that if you both seem to be willing to put in the effort. Like I said, you guys have matured together. You have grown up these last 3 to 4 years together. And I think that this is something that if you guys will always consider each other's feelings in every decision, that this is something that will last for all time. And we love you. And thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
That was so wonderful. It's great to hear from mom and to get a little bit more background on this incredible couple. It's at this point that I think I'll just take a couple of minutes to talk about love and spirituality just for a few minutes before then we turn the time over to this great couple to talk about their vows that they want to share with each other. I'm going to draw upon two of my favorite spiritual voices. One is Jesus. And regardless of how one feels about him religiously, to quote one of my favorite New Testament scholars, a Jewish woman who specializes in New Testament, she said, she was asked the question once, well, how did you, as a Jewish woman, become so obsessed with Jesus? And she said, well, Jesus had a lot of really smart things to say. And I loved the way that she summarized that. And he certainly did, particularly about love and how that should be manifest in the world. For Jesus, the most important thing was making heaven on earth in the here and now. Oftentimes, religious men and women get quite preoccupied in the hereafter and what that's going to be like. The reality is, regardless of our spiritual feelings on that matter or lack thereof, that's not something that most of us know very much about firsthand. But what we can focus on is this idea of making heaven on earth now for our loved ones, for our community, for the world as a whole. And in my mind, there is no better way to accomplish that than the type of love that we see manifest between the two of you. That unselfish, kind charity that leads you to care about another human being more than you care about yourself. I think the most impressive counsel that my father ever gave me when I got married was, he said, you know, David, a lot of people think that marriage is 50-50, that you got to do your part 50% and then your wife is going to have to do her part 50%. It's a 50-50 relationship, he said. But if you think about it, about 50% of the marriages don't last too long and end up terminating. And he said, because my perspective is you have to give 100%, not 50-50. Each individual needs to give 100% to the devotion and love and care of the other person. And if you do that, then you will be successful and experience great joy and lasting happiness, making heaven on earth for yourselves and for your family. The other great religious voice that I would draw upon is the Buddha, who's had a tremendous influence on my own life, and I hope to just share a little bit of his wisdom. The Buddha was an interesting person who balanced this life of extreme asceticism that was important in India at the time, versus extreme self-indulgence, and encouraged people to take a middle path between the two. And in the process, they would overcome suffering. And in this process of overcoming suffering, individuals would learn to live in the here and now and in the moment. And I think that message spiritually resonates with Jesus's concept of heaven on earth now. If we can learn to appreciate the beauty that is in love and in relationships in one another, appreciate the grass and the flowers and the mountains and the blue skies. If we can do that in the moment and focus now, it leads towards great lasting happiness. And it's a bit of advice that I would encourage you guys to implement as you start this incredible journey as husband and wife. We'll take the time now to let me get out of the way and let Wes and Abby share with each other the vows that they have arranged and put forward that are part of the promises that they are making to one another today on this beautiful occasion. So, mama number two.
Okay. Wesley. You have been my best friend, confidant, teacher, and my greatest challenge. The most... but But most importantly, you are the love of my life. You make me happier than I could ever imagine and more loved than I ever thought possible. You have made me a better person, as our love for one another has not only taught me to look for the good in others, but has taught me to love myself. I have been and always will be blessed to be a part of your life, which as of today becomes our life together. I wish I could stand up here and promise you the world, but the world isn't mine to give. What I do promise you is my world and all that comes with it. My love, support, passion, compassion, and enthusiasm. I promise to bring all of it in good times and bad. I see these vows not as promises, but as privileges. I get to laugh with you and cry with you, care for you and share with you. I get to walk, run, and skate with you, build with you and live with you. I get to have you be the person I spend the rest of my life with. I get to be there for you and support you. I don't have to honor and cherish you. I get to. I love you more than I can put into words, but I can promise that I'll never stop trying.
Okay, I guess I'll go next. There are places I'll remember, places that we have been and things we have seen. I remember the first time I saw you. You were wearing a Boba Fett t-shirt and a Star Wars backpack, and I knew you could be trusted. I knew it then, and I know it now. I'm standing across from you on a day that I hoped would happen since the day I met you. Since we listened to Radiohead on your bed, since we climbed mountains and walked through rivers and streams, since we listened to Lana all the way back home from Logan, since we happened upon each other and haven't looked back since. I will choose you every day for the rest of our lives and beyond. I will hold your hand through every hardship and every celebration, through laughter and tears, through loss and joy, through pain and good health. Tomorrow is not promised, which is even more reason to love you each day. There is no one that compares to you. We will not always see eye to eye or even share the same views. We will feel misunderstood or confused by each other. No matter what, and even on our darkest day, our friendship is uncompromising and our love is absolute. Even with troubles and joys ahead, you will always be my best friend and I will always love you. In my life, I'll love you more.
Much for sharing beautiful vows with each other and for with each of us on this incredible occasion. Perhaps we should move right now then to the exchanging of rings. No kissing yet, though. We're not quite there yet. I know you're ready. This beautiful spring day that has just given us so much light is a perfect reflection of what is transpiring here today in terms of love. There is no greater power in this universe than the power of human love in all of its varieties and forms and intricacies. And the love that you share for one another comes through in your eyes and in your feelings and in your faces. And it certainly is reflected in these incredible, beautiful vows that you've shared with one another as part of this marriage ceremony. Thank you for letting us be a part of that. on this incredible occasion, it is my privilege to bind the two of you in matrimony, to be able to put you together legally and lawfully as man and woman and as husband and wife, to care for each other, to love one another through sick, through health, through all circumstances that may transpire, including pandemics, to go forward and to let that love blossom that you share for one another, to warm the world, to warm your families, to warm your hearts of your siblings and your parents, your grandparents, and all those around you. Everyone will be blessed because of this incredible day where we link you together, not just as husband and wife, but as a family that will inspire the world. So by the powers that are vested in me as a minister of love, it is my privilege to legally and lawfully unify both of you, Wesley Hunter Cyphus and Abby Ludridge, as husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
My phone fell.
Hey, love you all so much. Thanks for tuning in. This is kind of awkward, but
yeah,
we really love you all. Thanks to the 69 people on YouTube and the 13 people on Facebook that have joined us. We love you. Thanks for hanging out with us. We're going to end it now, but hopefully see you later on today.
Yeah, if you can make it to the drive-by, come on by. We'd love to see everybody.
Love you all.
Bye.
Peace and love.
Oh, boy.